My name is Daniel Simon. I'm the QA services part of Axivion and the business unit of quality assurance. Oh, that's a very big challenge. So static code analysis is mainly looking at source code without executing it. That would be the very simple answer. And there's a lot more answers that we could add to that. So it's like looking at things that shift left in the development cycle, try to find errors early, being static code analysis as a safety net for development so that you don't miss out stupid errors that you introduce and report that back as early as possible during the life cycle of the software development process and as early as possible to the developers all the time without too much manual effort. Must be run mainly in the background without an additional hassle. People make mistakes, and when you're coding, in particular in regulated businesses like medical, automotive, aerospace, automation, everywhere where it's important that people do not get harmed, you just have to make sure that you don't introduce mistakes that could kill. So you need to apply all the tools that you can get to improve the quality. So usually the ROI comes from having better code, better maintainable code. We have some ROI models that indicate that we have up to 10 to 15% of return on invest into your development tool chain, which is in practice a little bit difficult to measure because people don't have too many numbers, but it's also on a different other level. So it's not only monetary, but it's also lowering project risk. It's improving your quality, your overall speed, your understanding of the code, and that's also your in return on the invest. For architecture verification, there's a very specific model that you can really calculate in euros or in dollars. So the main thing is that you save a lot of money when doing code analysis as a human. So the usual software development lifecycle for a first release of your software is just a small fraction of the overall total cost of ownership. And while you're evolving your software, it's half of the time you try to understand what you do. And architecture verification makes sure that you don't have any mistakes in the architecture, like hidden dependencies or unknown components, so that the efficiency and effectiveness of your maintenance work and understanding your code is increased drastically. Usually we assume that also from textbooks and our own research with our university collaborations, that we can save up to 10% of your efforts that you then can reinvest into future development, into more useful things than just understanding your old code. So learning from the past, it was maybe 10, 15 years ago, everybody was looking for MISRA checks, out-of-sort checks, and auditors in the regulated industries just, did you do the check? And the answer was usually yes, but nobody asked for the results. And nowadays they ask for the results, they want to see evidence. So what I see in the next years, we will more shift the focus also onto topics like the architecture. So you have all standards that request you to do static code analysis also ask you for having a high-level model, a low-level model, and the implementation. So that's mainly architecture checking. And auditors start to ask the question, what does your model have to do with your source code? Similar to what happened in the past with the MISRA standard, it's now more or less commodity, and they are asking the question, so you have to provide a useful answer and a reliable answer. And that is also something that's just putting pressure on the development. So you don't have to convince people anymore by giving them good arguments. They just have to do it.